That's why the Bible says it is very dangerous for the Christian to be a Christian without the Holy Spirit.
Come on,
it is very dangerous for a Christian without the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit, it is the Spirit that assists us, that guides us, that controls us, that leads us to the right direction. Because we cannot move to the right direction without the Holy Spirit. It is very dangerous for the Christian without the Holy Spirit. That Christian without the Holy Spirit, I feel very sorry for you to tell you that you are in trouble. Because it's only the Spirit of God that can lead you, that can take you, that can show you the right direction. It's only the Spirit of God. Let me say this thing to you. That's why the Bible says, after you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, the second step that you need to do is to be baptized. Once you baptize, the other step that you need to do is to accept the Spirit of God. It will depend. It might be first you receive the Spirit of God, or maybe you start by baptizing and then you receive the Spirit of God after. It will depend who comes first. But it's very, very important for the Christian to accept the Spirit of God, to be filled by the Spirit of God. Because if the Spirit of God is not in you, you are in trouble. These days, the only people who will survive is those. It's not for everyone. That's why the Bible says it's not for everybody who called me Jesus, or to call me Father, who will enter the kingdom of God. But it's for those who are doing the will of God. How you do the will of God? There's no way to do the will of God unless the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God. Let me say this thing before I continue with my subject. The Spirit of God is everything to us. I'm talking to you right now. Jesus is not here. Jesus is in heaven. We are the followers of Jesus. We are the disciple of Jesus, not the followers. We are the disciple of Jesus. As we are the disciple of Jesus, we need to be connected to Him. There's no way to be the disciple of Jesus without being connected to Him. Because He's the master, we are the learners. Oh my God. He's the master, we are the learner. As we are the learner, we need to be connected to your master. There is only way to be connected to your master is through Holy Spirit, not through your pastor. Your pastor is to teach you. Your pastor is to tell you that this is the way, this is how the thing's supposed to be. But the Holy Spirit will tell you, will connect you to the Father, the Son, the Father, the God, the Spirit that will lead you there. Your pastor is to teach you. So it's very dangerous.
Going goes.
The Christian without the Holy Spirit. Because if you don't have the Holy Spirit, it's not easy for you to discern. If this thing is right for God, or it's not right for God. Can I repeat my statement? If you don't have the Holy Spirit, it's not easy for you to discern.
This is the Spirit of God or not?
Because the Spirit of God helps you to discern. That's why the Christian of today, because they don't have the Holy Spirit, it's not easy for them to discern. Whatever that is in front of them, whatever, even, oh my
angazwe yishoni yonke into ephambi kwabo noma umuntu ophambi kwabo ebiza igama likaJesu bayaya lapho.
Because they don't have the Spirit of God.
Because
if you don't have the Spirit of God, it's not easy for you to have the discerning spirit. The discerning spirit comes from the Spirit of God. The discerning spirit is the spirit that is in you where other people, when other people say this is the right thing,
but
you can feel in your heart, you can feel in your heart, in your spirit, this is good if you look at it. But there's something in my heart that tells me that this thing is not hard. What is that? Is the discerning spirit with the Spirit of God, so that the Spirit of God will help us. The Spirit of God is helping us to know what is right. Now, the question: how to be holy? How to be holy? To be holy, you need to develop a holy lifestyle. A holy lifestyle. What is a lifestyle? A lifestyle. It's something that you live according to it. It's a lifestyle. It's something that you don't struggle to do it. Okay. The lifestyle, it's something that is in you. It's something that you adopt. It's something that you adopt and develop it inside you. When you are in